Hey guys, what's going on? It's me, Will Patterson. Today I'm going to be showing you how to design this incredible logo very easily in a very quick video. First thing I'm going to do is choose a font. I'm going to just write the letter R. I'm going to choose Montserrat. It's free, easy to use, and it's one of my favorites. I'm going to copy that over by pressing Alt and dragging. It'll just duplicate it. Now, I want this to be the sort of logo or the vintage monogram in the middle. You could do a lot of other things. You could create any design with the similar thickness of this. All I'm going to do is select this, Command Shift and O, and that will create outlines out of the text, making it into a shape rather than live text. The next thing I'm going to do is we're going to create the layout first of all. So we're going to create a circle, something like this. We're going to create another circle by copying and pasting and just dragging it inwards like this. And I'm going to change that to white. And I'm going to move this around a little bit, because what we're going to do is we're actually going to take these two circles and cut the white circle out of the black one. In Illustrator, we can highlight both of these, and by going to the Pathfinder tool over here, which you can find in Window, and then down to Pathfinder, we can press the second one in, which is minus front, which will minus the shape behind it that's on front. Bit confusing. What we're gonna do is shove that back here. We're gonna just scale this up a tiny bit more. Now this looks like the registered mark right now, but that's okay. We're gonna create another circle. We're gonna create this circle into just a path. So this path is now white. Now this path will serve as our type path, which means that we can actually write on this and the typography or the words will follow this. And the way that we do this is by going to the type tool over here, hold down, and we can go on type on path tool. Just click on the path and we can start, you know, writing anything. We're gonna write real world, and you'll see that it doesn't look very good right now. That's absolutely fine, because we could just change the actual size over here, like so. Now the only problem we have now is the typography is actually on top of the path. We want it to be in the middle. So with this highlighted, go to type. We're gonna go down to type on a path, and then type on a path options. From baseline, go to center, hit preview, and boom, it's in the center now of that path, which is what we want. Now you can see just here where my mouse is going, you'll see this little arrow pointing. This will signify where the typography should start and where it should end. So we're gonna do this, make sure it's on the one side and on the other. Then we're gonna justify the type to the middle. Now I'm gonna press Alt and just arrow space to track these out a little bit. There will be some kerning issues with this, because typography isn't meant to go around in a circle. So with that, you'll need to go in and just click in between a couple, go to Alt and just drag them in by pressing the arrow keys. And this will help you a lot when kerning different things. I like that. We're just gonna make this a tiny bit bigger, like so. And you can notice it's just conforming to this circle right there, which is great. Now what we're gonna do is copy and paste this. So press Command C and then Command F. Then press R to rotate, holding shift so it just rotates to the bottom, because we're gonna flip this. Now it's really easy to flip the words, because right now you see it looks like a mirror. Select this type, go up to type, type on a path, go to type on a path options, press preview to make sure, and press flip. Now we can change the letters in here. Something I like to do as well, a lot of people like to do this, is add little artifacts. It's supposed to be a vintage badge. You'll see a lot of these around, but they're pretty good designs. I quite like them. They're really simple. This is it. This is the basic part of it. But what I would suggest to do is to go even further, and it takes only a couple minutes to make this even better. What we can do is select this and just alt drag it, or you can create a new artboard and just drag it onto the new one. I prefer to do that. Makes everything a lot easier. We're going to highlight this and press Command Shift and O, which will outline all the shapes. So now the words are no longer live text. They are all shapes, as you can see. What I want to do is roughen this up. It looks way too clean. Vintage typography isn't supposed to be clean. It's supposed to be, you know, a bit rough and ready. So what I'm going to do is select this, and we're going to change this back into an image by going to Object, and we're going to rasterize. What this will do is when we press OK, it will use this as a real image. You'll see the white background there. It's a real image now. It's no longer a vector image. You can see the pixels there. The reason why we do this is because a really easy way of roughening things up a bit is by image tracing it back in. So we select the logo, and because we're selecting a shape, up here at the top, you'll see the word image trace. Just click that. Now you'll see it'll start doing some weird things, and you'll notice that, oh wait, it's vector again, but it looks a bit more rough. Well, that's what we're going for. But just so you know, you can go to this little box here, which will bring the trace panel up. Go to the preset black and white logo, bring the paths all the way down, corners all the way down, and noise all the way down, and you'll see that it gets even more rough as you go. But you need to find a happy medium of where it looks good and where it doesn't look like terrible. You just want it to have that little bit of used. That's it, that's perfect. Very important, press ignore white. That will ignore the white parts of the image, so Illustrator will know not to use that in the render. Press expand, and there you go. You've got your lettering and your logo there. The only thing we need to do now is actually make this look real. The way that I make my logo designs look the best in front of clients and in front of you guys is I show you them on mockups. It sort of bridges the gap between fantasy and reality. Now, Envato Elements are sponsoring this video, thankfully, because they have thousands, if not millions, of assets for you to download. Assets from fonts to textures to mockups, scene generators, audio, video template, logo reveals, logo animations, animation stuff, presets, anything you can think of, Envato Elements has it all inside their subscription. These mockups that you're seeing right now of me putting these on and making them look cool are all from Envato Elements, and they're included in the subscription. I can download anyone I like and use whatever I like in commercial projects. We use these mockups from Envato all the time in our commercial projects. One, we don't have to pay for our license every time we get one. We just have to use the simple license. You can read more about the licensing down below in the description. And it's super easy to know what you've downloaded. You can go back onto Envato, see which ones you've downloaded before, if you need to download it onto another computer to your work at home. The possibilities are there. You can do quite a lot with Envato. But if you click the link down below in the description, Envato Elements are giving you 50% off the annual subscription. That means that you get access to over 50 million assets for less than $20 per month. Wait, no, it's 55 million. How do you even have 55 million assets? I should do a video of me trying to download them all, seeing what would happen. It would break my computers. I'd have to buy like a data center. Anyway, click the link down below. You'll also get a free trial account for 7 days, so go and check it out if you want to see the free trial account to know what you're getting. I hope you learned something new in this video. It was designed just to show you a few little things that you may or may not know. If you did like this way of me doing a video, then let me know in the comments down below. Share the video if you enjoyed it. And if you don't know, you can subscribe. It's free and you can always unsubscribe later, so don't worry. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you in the next video. Goodbye.